Hello everyone, it's Zachary James. How are you all? What's new? Literally tell me everything. Tell me down in the comments before I even like start going into this video, you watch it. Like, just tell me what you're up to. I wanna know. I'm totally not going to use that as ideas of what I should do. Today I'm bringing you a fun little video. I just recently decided that I kind of wanted to do a what I'm reading during quarantine, and I just thought that would be... I am so sorry if there's like a random roar. I have my windows open and I should close them, but my room is so warm. Like all the heat rises and the sun like beats right into my bedroom, so... And I'm not gonna turn on the air conditioner because it's so loud, so if you hear like distant like... then it's cars passing by on the road, so I'm sorry. I decided that I just wanted to kind of tell you guys what I've been reading, kind of my ratings on some books, and like how I've been just like breezing through things between writing, of course, and between making videos and trying to produce other content that I can give you guys a little bit later. I can't talk about it yet, but there's a lot of stuff in the works right now. The first thing that I read at the very start of quarantine is Children of Eden by Joey Grissel. Children of Eden by Joey Graceffa. This is a middle grade dystopian, and it is actually really fun. It kind of is set in this world where it's post kind of apocalyptic, where the world has really deteriorated and been ruined over the course of time, and humanity put themselves into kind of a big like ecosystem where they can like sustain themselves through synthetic means of like synthetic food and plants and like produced oxygen and like all that fun stuff. But in this world for population control, there can only be one child per family. It kind of follows the perspective of our little queen right here. Her name is Rowan, and she is the twin sister to her brother. She is kind of jealous of him, and she decides to peer over the wall, and one day she climbs down. It is really action-packed. It's a lot of fun, and I really thoroughly enjoyed it. It is just like kind of a fast-paced read. It's really small, so I blew through it in almost one sitting, and I can't wait to read the sequel. I'm pretty sure the sequel is Elites of Eden, and then the last book is Rebels of Eden. So this book right here, 4 out of 5 stars for story. I should probably mention that these are in no particular order, so it's not like the order that I actually read them, just this is like the compilation of books that I read since the start of quarantine. Next on the list is Fire Falling by Elise Kova. I read this book. I had initially started it right after I finished Air Awakens, and I was obsessing, and then I read this book. I started it, I got about like 50 pages in, then I blew through the next 310 pages, and it was so good, and I stayed up super late reading it, and I'm absolutely obsessing over it. So this series, Air Awakens by Elise Kova, I will highly recommend it. Loved the first book, loved the second book. It's a little bit of a slow burn romance, and because this is a sequel, I don't really want to talk too much about the actual storyline, but if you want to find out a lot more about the Air Awakens series, you can watch my previous video from last week when I recommend it. And then next on the list that I'm currently reading at the moment is Earth's End. It is also by Elise Kova. It is book 3 inside of the Air Awakens series. I literally just started reading it the other day, and this is my one sitting read. I got to chapter 8, and I am obsessing over this book. I love the characters, and I love the slow burn romance. It's really like, everything's really culminating right now and really building towards a climax that I see in the future for this series. I really don't want it to end, I'm not gonna lie. I am just loving it so far. It's absolutely fantastic, and I'll probably be reading it right after this video. Next on the list is a book that I am actually in the process of reading as well, and it is a reread. So I am currently reading Onyx and Ivory by Mindy Arnott. I decided that I was going to reread this book so I could actually hop into the sequel and do like kind of like a binge read. This is the sequel, Flame and Shadow, Shadow and Flame. Came out in kind of the beginning of 2019, I'm pretty sure. I decided that I wanted to immediately read the sequel of this book right after, and I kind of forgot a lot of this when I read it the first time, so now that I'm reading it the second time, I'm thoroughly enjoying it. It follows two main perspectives. Corwin, he is a prince, and also Kate, she is the daughter of a man who tried to assassinate Corwin's father. It is really fun, it's really adventurous. They live in a world where monsters kind of come out of the ground at night. They call them night drakes, and essentially they have to use magical spells to try and keep them away from like their main citadels. And like when there's the relay riders who like deliver mail and like pass messages on, that's what Kate is. So because she's a relay rider, she is out of like the safety of the city, and she's constantly traveling to try and deliver mail messages. Soon they start noticing that the night drakes don't only come out at night, and I feel like I'm just gonna leave it at that because it just builds so well. This romance is very tense and it's so fantastic, and I absolutely love this book so far, and I'll probably be finishing it very shortly, probably right after I finish Earth's End. Next is a big book. It is the fourth in a series, and it is Warstorm by Victoria Aveyard, and yes, I did get the signed copy from Barnes & Noble. This book is the last in the series besides the Bind Up of Novellas with like an exclusive epilogue that's Broken Throne that came out a year after this one released. So this one also just came out in paperback as well, but it is the big finale, the final battle, and truthfully, I really liked it. I know there was a lot of mixed reviews on this book itself. I do give this book a 5-star rating just for the fact that it was ended in such a way that is never done in YA. It felt so much more honest and real between the characters, and I really think that it was a creative decision of Victoria's to kind of speed along this ending and not necessarily rush it, but life moves so fast, and especially when you're inside of a war kind of setting, it paces itself and like everything starts to build up, and sometimes the giant explosive battle, which there is a giant explosive battle, isn't going to be 100 pages long, and I think it's just was done really well. I think it really does neatly wrap up most of the story, but it also kind of leaves a door open for companion novels and spin-off book, War Story by Victoria Aveyard. Okay, I'm sorry if there's like a slight kind of shift in the camera. My camera battery ended up dying. All we missed was just one last book, and that is House of Earth and Blood by Sarah J. Maas. It is the first book in her adult series, and that series is titled Crescent City, and it follows the perspective of Bryce Quinlan. She is the sole survivor of a mass murder of her friends, and she kind of gets sent on a quest multiple years later to find the killer and find the truth of what happened. It is a fantastic story. I absolutely loved it. I found myself crying and laughing, and it does have a lot of sexual tension, which I'm never gonna complain about, but this book is just definitely a 10 out of 5 stars in my opinion, and I really think anyone who is trying to get more into high fantasy or even just prefers urban fantasy but would like to try fantasy, this is the perfect book. It blends a lot of those elements and it does it really well. House of Earth and Blood by Sarah J. Maas. That is all I have for you today on books that I read during quarantine, so please tell me down below what books you're reading during quarantine. Are you not reading at all? Are you catching up on TV shows? Are you watching fun movies? Tell me down in the comments. Please make sure that you subscribe, like, and comment, or even share if you would like, and check out my video from last week. Last week I talked about what I want to do with this channel and also some fantasy book recommendations. So I hope you have a great day. Keep reading, keep writing, and I can't wait to see you again.